to my channel Cooking with Mithisha.
Today I'm gonna show you how to make restaurant style paneer butter masala or paneer makhani the easiest way. So let's get started.
To make paneer butter masala, here I have roughly chopped onion, roughly chopped tomatoes, cube paneer, ginger garlic paste, cashew nuts, about 15 to 16 piece of cashew nuts, fresh cream, butter, and dry fenugreek powder. So quantity here I'm using, it is enough for 5 people. So you can adjust the quantity according to your preference. And for the spice, I will be adding garam masala and chili powder. So here I'm heating a pan. Into that, I'll add just a little bit of oil. That's it. And into this, I'll add my cashew nuts, all of my tomatoes, and chopped onion. Into this, I'll add a little bit of salt. Mix it up. That's it. I'm going to cover this and let this cook until onions and tomato gets nice and soft. Let's check on it. Perfect. You can see it got really nice and soft. And tomatoes are almost dissolved. So now I'm going to turn off this stuff. And now we are going to puree this into a blender. You can wait until it's cooled down because it's really hot, or you can add a little bit of cold water to it. I'm gonna add a little bit of water. So our puree is ready. And I'm using same pan, and into this pan we'll add our butter. Let your butter melt. So after your butter melt, you want to add your ginger garlic paste, 2 tablespoons. Let it saute for a minute. Right, so this is almost done. And into this, I'll add teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder for color. This is not regular chili powder, it is not spicy. So just for the color, I'm adding this chili powder, Kashmiri chili powder. Mix it. And you just want to make sure you don't need your chili powder. This will give nice color to your dish. And we'll be adding regular chili powder, the spicy one, later on. Now it's time to add our puree. I'm going to use the strainer to sieve this puree. This way we will get really nice smooth gravy, and this is optional. If you want that restaurant style smooth gravy, then do it. You can see this is all like from tomato skin and cashew which didn't grind well. And I also added a little bit of water. Mix it. So after mixing it well, I'm going to let this gravy simmer for about 7 to 8 minutes. So let's check. You can see it has simmered very nice, and it's a little thicker than before. Time to add the rest of the ingredients. Now I'll add 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder. You can adjust all this spice according to your preference, how spicy you like. Garam masala, 1 teaspoon. This is kasuri methi. I forgot to show you 2 ingredients, which I'll show you now. So my first ingredient here, I have cardamom powder. So I'm gonna add a big pinch of cardamom powder. This is optional, but it will give nice like aroma to your paneer sabji. And then second is, either you can add sugar or honey. I'm gonna add honey. So I'm gonna squeeze a little bit of honey. You can use sugar if you want. I'm going to add my cream. Mix it all together. And a little bit of salt. I have added salt before, so I'm going to watch and my salt. So after mixing it all together, give it a taste. Because after adding cottage cheese or paneer, you don't want to mix it too much, otherwise you will break the paneer pieces. So you want to give it a taste right now before you add your paneer. So very last, I'll add my paneer cubes into it. Stir in your paneer cubes gently. Our curry is almost done. What I'm going to do, cover it and let it simmer for only 2 minutes, because the paneer we have added, the cottage cheese we have added, need to absorb a little bit of flavor. So I'm going to cover it and let it simmer for only 2 minutes. It's been 2 minutes. Let's check. We are ready to serve this. So our paneer butter masala is ready to enjoy, and now I'm just going to garnish a bit with this finely chopped cilantro and with some fresh cream. Hope you have enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, share this recipe with your friends and family, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye.